Hello, welcome to Creator Sessions. My name is Tiffany Day. I'm very, very excited to be here today. For those of you who don't know who I am a 21-year-old independent artist based in Los Angeles, California.
You're such a cloud chaser, up in my skin, trying to get in for all the wrong reasons. I'm falling apart, but you think it's ours, so baby, just leave me. I'm sick and tired of failures, like a book on a shelf, put it back in you now, we'll pick it up again, so you don't deserve a friend. Yeah, yeah, up in my skin, no.
Tiffany Day has been one of the artists that I have been the most inspired and excited about sharing. She's young, cool, way cooler than me, that's for sure, and has a huge career ahead of her. She grew up in Kansas, making music in her basement, and after just a few years, her YouTube channel amassed over 1 million subscribers. Though her goal isn't necessarily to be a YouTuber, it's more about making art that she's proud of, and she is doing that. I thought that I liked her based solely on her music and her vibe, but in the first 2 minutes of talking with her, she immediately just pulled me in and I was hanging on every word because she is as authentic as it gets. She said this about making her music. The main thing that I want people to feel when they hear my music is inspiration, inspiring them to be confident in themselves and to just be bold. She said, I like to say F it and do whatever I want to do because life is so much more fun that way. During this creator session, she shares some releases from her EP, The Recovery Project, and also some unreleased music as well. If you are an artist, I would love to hear in the comments what inspired you. And if you are a fan, tell us what song you connected to the most.
Today, I'm going to be singing a couple songs, and I'm also just going to be talking to you about my journey and how I kind of came to be the artist that I am today, as well as some like things that I've learned, things that I want to share, things that I wish I had known earlier on in my career, and just cool motivational stuff. So I'm going to sing a song, talk about it. We're just kind of going to go with the flow and keep it as candid and as real as possible. So without further ado, this is my first song of the day / night / whatever time you're watching this video, and it's called Feel Alright.
Just know that I'm not. Learned how to be on my own. I forgot what love's supposed to feel like. What I'm supposed to feel like when you're holding my hand. All I feel is it's not. That the piss I like is waiting to ride. I don't wanna be like. I don't wanna be like an empty face on the screen. Caught up with what people think of me. A better dough cash machine. Trapped it inside of my wildest dreams. And if I could escape my mind, maybe for an hour, maybe I would find a better place to rest my eyes. So I could feel alright. I never asked for it, I repeat. I never asked for it, and all my friends ain't nothing. They don't don't understand how the hell they got me feeling like a thankless bitch. Yeah, done with these people, I'm done with this moment. I'm done feeling guilty about the things I can't control. You must think that I'm so ungrateful. Yeah. Think that I'm special, just know that I'm not. Learned how to be on my own. I forgot what love's supposed to feel like. What I'm supposed to feel like when you're holding my hand. All I feel is this night. Tied up inside like it's waiting to ride. I don't wanna be like. I don't wanna be like. An empty face on a screen, caught up with what people think of me. A better dough cash machine, trapped it inside of my wildest dreams. And if I could escape my mind, maybe for an hour, maybe I would find a better place to rest my eyes, yeah, so I could feel alright.
I always find it kind of awkward after I finish a song when I'm recording with the camera, just because you're so used to, you know, performing on stage with an applause, and then all of a sudden now everything is just you in front of a camera. However, the old YouTuber in me feels this and understands this, so I'm okay with it. But yeah, that was Feel Alright. That's actually one of my favorite songs off of my EP that just came out back in January called The Recovery Project. It's really cool because I never really imagined myself being able to play guitar like this well. I wouldn't even say this well. I'm not like a goddess at it. However, I never really imagined myself to be able to do that at the same time, just because I'm somebody who likes to really focus on my vocal performance over like any other instrument that I play. But I realized that the more time that you spend actually doing it, it really just becomes muscle memory. And it's crazy too, because I am self-taught with guitar. I never thought that I could be at this level just being self-taught, but the internet is a crazy cool place, and I learned a lot from the internet. And I'm gonna talk more about my guitar journey too as we continue on in the set. But yeah, that was my first song. And now I'm going to sing you another song from my first EP. This is called Pretend, and I'm switching over to my electric guitar, so we will make the switch. I name my guitars because I just love making everything very personal, and this guitar's name is Tofu, because I really like tofu. Before I start singing this song, I actually had stuff to talk about for this song specifically, just because this is actually the first song that I ever brought into a studio in Los Angeles. And the craziest part of all of it is the fact that I actually recorded the vocals on this song. The actual current version that's out right now on Spotify and everywhere on all streaming platforms was recorded on my $100 Blue Yeti USB mic when I was 18 years old, and I'm 21 now, if that gives you some sort of reference. So first off, I've been sitting on the song for a very long time, and that's a whole nother story. But it's just very amazing to me, and I don't think I understood this until later on, how crazy important a really good mix is for your song. The fact that I recorded these vocals on like a very, very cheap microphone, yet the vocal still sounded so rich and lovely, was all thank you to my favorite mixer, one of my favorite mixers, Jesse Ray Ernster, who did an amazing job mixing the whole song. But it goes to show that you don't necessarily need expensive equipment to make really good music. It's mainly what you do to the recordings or the music that you make to make it sound good. So yeah, this is Pretend. I'm really excited about the song. I actually found the chords for this song based solely off ear. If you know me in real life, which most of you don't, but I feel like you could probably find this out if you dug a little bit. I don't know any music theory really at all. I was in classical piano when I was young for a couple years, but I didn't really learn a lot about the scales and the diatonic chord. I don't even know the names of stuff, but everything that I find on the guitar comes strictly from my ear. And I remember one night I was in my bedroom in Kansas and I really just put my fingers on the guitar and I found these chords and I was like, whoa, these sound super cool. So even if you ask me to this day, I don't know what the names of the chords are, but they sound cool. And that's another tip. I love how I'm giving tips. I'm not a pro here. This is just stuff that works for me. And I hope that in some sort of way, it inspires you to maybe just unleash your creativity and think that you do have what it takes, because you do have what it takes. Anyways, okay, enough rambling. This is Pretend. Okay.
I need a distraction. So break off your connection. Yeah, I want your attention. I need a distraction from you, baby. All my friends think I'm crazy, and maybe they make a good point, but I play pretend, knowing fully that you could just tear my heart up again. I can't seem to just say no, and I said I'd be smart, but you play with my heart, boy. You keep hitting on my phone, and I fall every time. I just can't seem to hide. I'm dying, being played like a fool. Dying, playing games by the rules. I'm just getting over, and my heart gained some closure. But you keep walking into my life every time, and I run back to you closer. All my friends think I'm crazy, and maybe they make a good point, but I play pretend, knowing fully that you could just tear my heart up again. I can't seem to just say no, and I said I'd be smart, but you play with my heart, boy. You keep hitting on my phone, and I fall every time. I just can't seem to hide. I'm dying, being played like a fool. Dying, playing games by the rules. Dying, being played like a fool. Dying, playing games by the rules.
Okay, next song. But before next song, I want a sip of water, because we're making this as realistic as possible. So, Okay, so this next song is a song that actually came out a while ago when I think I was still trying to find my sound. It's called I'm Sorry, and it's actually also one of the first songs that I ever collaborated with other people on. Growing up in Kansas, I had literally zero music people to do zero music things with, and so it was usually just me in my bedroom alone with Kaya, my acoustic guitar, and the two of us would just sit for hours, come up with chords, and write stuff. And so for the first time ever, when I moved out to LA, I started meeting other people, and I got into a session with some of my day ones now, but it was Austin Ward, Cecil Bernardi, and Majors. And the three of them, I remember feeling kind of intimidated just because it was our second or third time working together, and I didn't even know how the dynamic works in a studio. I never have written with people in the room either. And so it was just a very scary but also very exciting process. And I remember it all came about so naturally. We didn't even necessarily talk about what music we were going to make. We didn't even talk about what the vibe was. I just remember Austin started playing these beautiful chords, and I just sat there and I really just listened. And, you know, they started tracking it down, and eventually I was like, you know, what could be really cool here and there. And we all kind of just like chipped our own parts into the song, and then the song just came to be what it is today. It was actually a very beautiful, humbling experience. And I honestly think it taught me a lot about the value of other people chipping in. A lot of times I feel like as artists, we want to take pride in like, we do everything ourselves. I wrote this, I produced this, this and that. But like, sometimes it's good to be just a little humble and like work with your collaborators, because at the end of the day, I feel like the most important thing is how beautiful the art is and not necessarily like who made it. And so I just think that sometimes more people that you have on a song or in the creation process in general, the more unique and beautiful and better it could probably be. So that being said, this is I'm Sorry, and I'm gonna use my little loop pedal on the ground. I don't really use guitar pedals, but this is the only guitar pedal I own, and it's simply so that I can noodle on top and do a little soloing on the electric. So.
Turned around and looked in the mirror, thinking this could be the time I finally felt like I was a winner. Then I saw everything that I need, didn't think that you'd be missing. Tell me, love, what's it all gonna be? How do I stop the bleeding? I'm sorry for breaking your heart and tearing you apart. Don't love me. You know I'm no good for you, baby. Don't start to warn me. I made a mistake and I just need some time. I'm sorry, so sorry, yeah. I don't understand why you've been so broken, lying on the don't understand why you've been so broken, lying on the into this mess, but you know we won't stay here forever. Thinking about you less and less, my heart was gone when we were together. So I saw everything that I need, didn't think you'd be missing. How do I let you go so free? How do I stop the bleeding? I'm sorry for breaking your heart and tearing you apart. Don't love me. You know I'm no good for you, baby. Don't start to warn me. I made a mistake and I just need some time. I'm sorry, so sorry, yeah. No.
fade. But I can't fade with my foot. Thank you. Okay. All right. So that was I'm Sorry. So beautiful. Always puts me in a very nostalgic mood.
Don't worry, we still have more music with Tiffany, but I wanted to close out here. Something that really inspired me about Tiffany was one of her reasons for pursuing this dream that was so important to her. She said that as an Asian American, she didn't see herself reflected in the media when she was growing up, and she wanted to change that in an effort to make other Asian Americans feel more confident, especially young women. I think it's one of the reasons that she writes and performs with such a boldness. She is doing exactly what she has set out to do in creating beautiful art alongside that mission. And lastly, I really love this next part of the session because we get to hear some unreleased music, and she also drops some affirmations that you don't need the best equipment, lessons, or formal training to make it in music. Now, I can't say this for certain, and I definitely don't predict the future, but I am confident that Tiffany's career in music is only in its infancy because her North Star is her art, as you'll hear her elaborate on next. If you love Tiffany, please follow her, support her, and subscribe to this channel to see more inspiring content from our favorite creators. As always, I am Haley, and thank you for joining us on Creator Sessions.
So, I'm back with Kaya. We're about to play the last two songs of the set. I want to talk about this one a lot because I love this song. It's probably one of my favorite songs I've ever written. I actually don't know if I have solid plans to ever release it, but I will say it's probably one of the most fun songs I've ever written. Around this time, 1 year ago, when things got shut down and I went back home to Kansas, my mom had me live in my basement for 2 weeks. And in those 2 weeks, I was really able to just lock in with my guitar and my brain. I'm somebody who, they call me a fast session writer. So I usually pull up to a studio, we work on the beat, and then I usually have a top line or something done in like 30 minutes. And don't get me wrong, it's catchy, it's cool, but it's not as intimate as it would be when I used to write songs by myself alone in my bedroom in Kansas. And so being back at home and being in my basement for 2 weeks alone gave me this big opportunity to kind of get back into the zone after a year of completely just writing with other people and being in big, busy sessions. And so it was a really, really humbling experience to kind of strip everything down and just go back to my roots. And it made me feel a lot more patient with my words and my work in general. Usually I'll write something and I'll just kind of throw it to the side and I'm like, all right, I'm done with it. But this one actually took me a solid 2 to 3 days. I spent quite a while on it. And I actually wrote the verses and then I was like, nah, the verse just doesn't hit right. And so I actually rewrote the verses and I spent time just kind of like listening to it over and over again. I think the idea and the concept of familiarity is really important in that sense, just because your ears get so kind of in tune to one thing that you really have to break out and kind of explore other things as well. And so it was almost like fighting familiarity, which is crazy. I usually don't ever come back to songs to visit them and kind of change them. So this song is kind of my independence anthem. I was in kind of a rough, toxic relationship back last year. And, you know, it had ended and I went on a solo trip to San Francisco. My very first solo trip ever, I went to a city where I knew zero people. I just booked an Airbnb for 5 days and I spent my days exploring the city, eating food that I wanted to eat, going to places that I wanted to see. I'd go to parks and I'd sit under the sun and paint and journal and meditate. And it was such a beautiful trip. And I got to write about it in the song as well. And so the song is just very, very personal to me. And it's one of my favorites that I've ever written. So enough rambling. This is What Doesn't Want Me.
I talk to myself at night. You might think it's weird, but boy, I'm fine. I come for myself when I cry. You might think I need you by my side. Well, I don't need to think about it. Yeah, I'm better off without it. And my happiness don't come from what you do. It's a joke, you think you broke me. Well, the truth is you don't know me. I won't stay to cry my eyes out over you. 2, 3, I need to tell myself that I don't want what doesn't want me. me, boy, come show me before I get up and leave. Cause I'm not scared to lose anyone in love with who I've become. I don't need to love you too, yeah. Just need to tell myself that I don't want what doesn't want me. See, I took a trip to San Francisco to find my soul and all of that bullshit. But no, I ain't kidding when I tell you I became part of myself again. No more suffering, happiest I've ever been. Introspection medicine, I'm on my team, but where are you? Ooh, don't need to think about it, yeah, I'm better off without it. And my happiness don't come from what you do. It's a joke, you think you broke me. Well, the truth is you don't know me. I won't stay to cry my eyes out over you. 2, 3, I need to tell myself that I don't want what doesn't want me. Yeah, and if you want me, boy, come show me before I get up and leave. Cause I'm not scared to lose anyone in love with who I become. I don't need to love you too, yeah. Just need to tell myself that I don't want what doesn't want me. What doesn't want me? What doesn't want me? No, 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 no. What doesn't want me? Ooh, yeah. What doesn't want me? What doesn't want me? No, 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 no.
Thank you. All right, cool. So we've made it to the very last song of the set. This is by far probably my favorite piece of art that I have ever made in terms of music. And that's because this is a song that I actually produced by myself. And never in a million years did I think that I could produce music. But before I explain that, I'm gonna take a sip of water because my throat is getting dry, so. It's like ASMR. Okay, so this song is called Cloud Chaser. I like to say that I don't have favorite songs because I love all my songs equally, but this is 100% my favorite song that I think I've ever written, and also just the production of it too. I wrote this song at the end of my freshman year of college back in 2019, summer of 2019. I had just been out in LA for a full year, pretty much, a full school year, and I had been exposed for the first time in my life to all these studios, all these producers, and I started secondhand learning. So the producers didn't actually like teach me directly. I kind of just like peeped over their shoulders and like watched as they put different plugins, watched as they put different kick patterns and this and that, and I just kind of observed from afar. And here and there I would ask them a question like, hey, what plugin is that, or this and that. And eventually I started being able to become very fluent in these DAWs that they were using by myself. And I remember I got home from freshman year that summer, and I remember sitting in my bedroom and I was like, all right, now's the time. I woke up, it was like 9 a.m. in the morning, and I was like, let's just sit down and mess around, you know? And eventually what came out was this song, Cloud Chaser. And I think the craziest part is that I was so proud of it. After I finished it, I sent it to all my producer friends. And I was like, guys, look what I just made by myself. And they were all like, wow, this is amazing, Tiffany. This sounds very like influenced by the music that we've been making. And at that point, I realized, whoa, like that makes a lot of sense. I think the more and more you develop your sound, the more you fall deeper into who you are as an artist and what you sound like. So I guess the more you just fall deeper into your sound. For me, the one big thing was triple kicks. Boom, boom, boom. I don't know why, but I really, really like triple kicks. And so I remember when I was producing it out, I was like, I'm gonna add some triple kicks in there. And it just felt very Tiffany Day. And I was so proud of it. So. That being said, all of this is to say, you don't need like lessons. You don't need like a mentor. I learned things from a secondhand kind of perspective, but you could learn so many things online. We live in a world right now where the internet is so accessible. And I learned a lot from the internet too, actually. It wasn't just the producers. I learned a lot from the internet. But that's all to say, if you want to do it, you can do it. So, because I did it, and this is living proof for the fact that you could do it too, because trust me, I didn't think I could do it, but here we are. All right, so this last song is called Cloud Chaser, and I'm gonna stop rambling and just play it.
So you wanna use me? Think you're gonna lose when I tell you that I'll never see in you again. Yeah. Now I gotta teach you something. Can't you see the person you're becoming? Gotta tell you, I don't think I'm ever seeing you again. You see me from on first, yeah. Don't think that I never noticed. Call each other for another, cause I don't want you up in my skin, trying to get in for all the wrong reasons. I'm falling apart, but you think it's ours, so baby, just leave me. I'm sick and tired of being used, like a book on a shelf. Put it back and you never pick it up again. So you don't deserve a friend, yeah. Yeah, up in my skin, yeah. Oh, yeah, falling apart. Go around downtown, showing love on my name, I appreciate it. But you always take it too far when you're telling other people that we're doing so amazing. But you don't know me, baby. You see me for no bars, yeah. Don't think that I never noticed. Call each other for no third, cause I don't want. I don't want you. I need you far, far away from me. You're such a cloud chaser. Up in my skin, trying to get in for all the wrong reasons. I'm falling apart, but you think it's ours. So baby, just leave me. I'm sick and tired of me. Like a book on the shelf, put it back in you now, we'll pick it up again. So you don't deserve a friend, yeah, yeah. Up in my skin, no, yeah. Falling apart,
How my fingers hurt after that. Okay, that concludes my set. But before I leave my creator session, I want to say thank you for tuning in. If you are an aspiring musician, if you are somebody who wants to be involved in the arts, the biggest piece of advice that I could ever give you is to focus on your art and to understand that. First off, you got to set your intentions. That's the biggest thing. And my biggest intention is focusing on the art. So I get it. If you want the numbers, if you want the fame, if you want the money, that makes sense. Those are all kind of exterior motives for this and that. But I think the only true way to actually succeed and be respected, which I desire respect more than anything else, is by making really good art. And so a lot of times when you lose yourself in everything else, the one thing that really keeps me grounded is the fact that I am an artist and I make art. That being said, I hope that maybe that piece of advice can help you when you potentially get too lost, your head goes 27 different places at one time. I just think that it's really important to stay true to who you are, to almost kind of exaggerate and take you, the real you, times 10 and make that artist you. Don't try and be something that you're not. Create things from your heart. As cheesy as that sounds, it is the truth. It is what will help you become successful. And, you know, that's not a guaranteed thing. Look at me now. I'm not, like, crazy successful. However, I'm getting there, and I'm continuously growing every single day. And I think it's because I set my intentions, and I keep them away from all of the worldly, superficial things. Because at the end of the day, I really think that the art should be the most important thing that really matters to any artist. Hence, that's why they're called artists. We're artists, you know? Anyways, that was my piece of advice. Thank you all so much for tuning in. I hope that you have an amazing day, night, rest of your day, night, wherever you are. And yeah, that's it. If you've never heard of me before, if you want to find more about me, you can find all of my social media tags at Tiff Did What. Like, Tiff Did What? It's supposed to be like quirky and clever because Tiffany Day was taken. But you can find me on like Twitter, Instagram, and everything, and streaming platforms at Tiffany Day. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all one day in the future, hopefully. Okay.